here or are standing up somewhere, I'm going to ask you to please make welcome to the stage the co-convener of the 60th Australian National Square Dance Convention, Mr. Barry Chandler. Please make him welcome.
Fellow dancers, ladies and gentlemen, we are now at the conclusion of the formal part of the convention and therefore some things need to be said. This convention, I'm sure, maintained Tasmania's high reputation, providing a good blend of all aspects expected for national conventions. Tasmania has again followed some established traditions, and with any luck, set some others. We trust that we have provided a good mix of cause and cures for your dancing pleasure, and I take the opportunity to thank them again on your behalf for volunteering their time and efforts at this convention. The aim of the committee in programming this convention was to maximise the amount of dancing time available to you, the dancers. And I hope that we have achieved that and you have all enjoyed this convention. Events of this magnitude do not just happen. In this regard, I express particular thanks to the hard-working and dedicated committee. To them, this is what they have worked for over 3 years. The committee itself had some notable strategic problems in preparing for this event. Examples being several members resigning, telephone numbers being misprinted, booking the hall not being confirmed till 6 weeks ago, local councils, members stationed some 3 hours away from meeting venues, and some legal technicalities, and most recently the program print errors. But we made it. The committee didn't stand on ceremony of positions. If something had to be done, it was just done. And I would now like to introduce the team of Kay Chandler, Di Ashton, Katie Matthews, Nelson Cooper, Sandra Hazel, and Paul Ashton. I know they all deserve our sincere appreciation for organising such a great event. Furthermore, I extend our appreciation to all the others that have helped with this convention. And in particular, I must note Des Dickinson, who has provided the sound and his ever-trusted crew. And Andrew, would you like to come out here, please? This little guy's been stuck in that box all weekend. Delorraine Rotary, who have provided your refreshments. The creche staff, who will look after and care for the children in the creche. And Vander Valley Council, who's catered for our every need in this venue. The Delorraine Bowls Club, who looked after every aspect in regards to the secondary venue. The Launceston Square Dance Club, who helped with the decorations and setting up, and especially Star Charlotte Snow, who coordinated all the decorations. Robert Etchell, who provided such a superb backdrop with Paul and other structural requirements, including this great big diamond. And finally, we must thank Heather McLaughlin, who looked after her introduce, and I hope there wasn't too much. But she only knew a week ago she was doing that. For anybody that I may have missed, thank you. Please accept our sincere appreciation, because this convention could not have been achieved without the assistance of you all. To you, the dancers, especially those that were troubled distances, along with any of our international visitors, thank you.
Now, just before we close this convention, I remind you all that this is not the finish of our program. For tomorrow night, we're all going to have one bling of a time with our trail out dance, and we ask you all to come along dressed in something glitz, glamour, diamonds and bling, dress it up in 2019. However, please be mindful of your shoes. With this in mind, I now welcome to the stage to close this convention and to introduce the co-conveners of the 61st Australian National Square Dance Convention, the Chairman of the Australian National Square Dance Board, Mr. Neb McLaughlin.
First of all, it's my humble duty, first of all, to acknowledge Barry Chandler, because not only is he convener of this convention, and this convention is now over, but Barry has relinquished the leadership of the National Convention Board after 16 years. So I'd like to please acknowledge Barry and understand why he is so amazing. I'd also now like to thank the committee and all of the helpers of the 60th Australian National Square Dance Convention, and I'd like to present you with a little token of appreciation on behalf of all of the dancers. National Committee will hand over the convention banner, and with that, I can't say that it's a pleasure to close the 60th Australian National Square Dance Convention. Would you please put your hands together for this convention? With this for long, I'm going to ask the co-conveners of the 61st Australian National Square Dance Convention to come onto the stage. I'm going to pass this banner over to them. I'm going to leave it in capable hands, and I'm going to also leave this microphone to you to introduce your committee. Thanks, everybody.
Hard act to follow, don't you think? I did. Wasn't that fantastic? I was saying to some people, some dancers at the back earlier, that sometimes the dance community really doesn't know what goes on with the prep of a national convention. We're kind of learning that now. For those of you who don't know us, this is my wife Rosalind, and I'm David Todd. So we're going to start off with a couple of little things. We're going to just put a little bit of music on to bring everybody on, bring on our committee. So a little bit of we're going to bring them on right now. Here we go. Wow. We've got, there's a reason why they've got their back to you, because we're going to introduce them as well, but we'll get to that in just a sec. We're just going to just give you a little bit of background on the Blue Mountains and what we're about. We're inviting all of you guys and dolls to join us as we relive the golden age of the spectacular Blue Mountains region in April 2020. And the theme is called Putting on the Ritz.
Come and join us for dancing in the ballroom, sweeping staircases and beautiful marbleized columns to capture the elegance of days gone by.
The early 1920s saw the tourism industry in the Blue Mountains born. With this boom came entertainment and rivalry music and dancing, architecture and artwork. The Art Deco character of the 20s defines the Blue Mountains, and it is today found in street front facades, iconic guest houses and beautiful gardens.
Autumn is the season when Mother Nature really puts it on a show in the Blue Mountains, when the region becomes a sea of brilliant red, yellow and flame orange colours. You can enjoy the crisp, fresh mountain air. Perhaps not as crisp and fresh as the air in Tasmania.
Better add that, what I want to say. Our sponsors, Fantastic Aussie Tours, have provided a range of opportunities to explore this region and delight you with all the mountains have to offer. As you may have known when you've been out the back looking around at what we're doing there, Fantastic Aussie Tours have got customised tours designed for you. If you haven't got a brochure for that, please go and get one, because there are half-day tours, and this all starts at the ACF conference as well, so that's for the partners.
All right, introducing our committee who are here today. All right, starting with our secretary, Louise Anderson. Our treasurer, David Calvert and Georgina Calvert. Our publicity manager, Suzanne Horvath. Our registrar, Rufina Cheng. And I must say, Rufina has been very busy in the last couple of days. Our grand dance manager, Helen Hodel, and Anna Lee, who's our youngest member of our team. Our artistic director, and her husband Ron, Marie Hufferdine. And what would we be without our board liaison officer, Gordon Hearn? So, and last but not least, general committee members, Ralph and Helen Jenner. So don't miss out your chance to relive the golden age of Blue Mountains. We're putting on the Ritz, April 2020, Blue Mountains Grammar School at Wentworth Falls. Now, we're going to ask Anna Lee to come up.
So we're also going to do our draw for our free registration. And by the way, like we have, I think today we've had about 270 registrations. Would that be close to the mark?
279.
No, you are. Thank you so much for participating. We're going to get Siri to pick a winning number.
Hey Siri, pick a number between 1 and 279.
That would be 159.
159 is our winner, and we're going to come back a little later and we're going to actually announce who that winner is, because we have all the information out the back with us now, so be a little patient with us for that. We're just going to pop the music on so we can let you get on with your dancing. We look forward to seeing you in the Blue Mountains. Should be lots of fun. Here we go. Thanks, everybody.